Hello,
my name is Miss Willery.
And I'm Miss Tinsman.
And we teach kindergarten
at Chapelwood Elementary.
Today's science lesson will be about
how animals are alike and different.
And here is Mr. Rick Crosslin.
Thank you. Hello. So in the last couple weeks, we've been studying animals, right? And we learned about how animals move. In fact, there's an animal that that moves by flying. What was that?
Birds.
Birds. And there's an animal that moves in the water by using its fins. What's that?
Fish.
And then there's an animal that uses its legs to...
A frog,
a kangaroo, or even a...
Bunny rabbit.
And then there's some animals that run really fast.
Cheetah.
So we got... Oh, there's one other animal that... It doesn't fly, it doesn't swim, it doesn't hop, it doesn't run, but it...
Snake!
And it's snakes. What do you describe that movement? Yes?
Slither.
Everybody say it.
Slither.
Slither. So that was 1 week. Then last week we talked about what animals are covered in. And now I'm covered in skin, you're covered in skin, but I'm a type of animal that is covered also in...
Hair
or fur. In fact, I got hair right here. I even got hair on my lips.
What? It's called
a mustache.
Are you a beard?
And a beard too. So we do are covered with skin and hair. But there's three other things that animals are covered in. We learned last week that some of them are covered in. Well, let me think. Okay, what is? I'm thinking of an animal that has fur. It has four legs. It as the fur can be long or short. The fur has a tail and it can run fast and it makes a noise like this. What animal is covered in fur? What do you think, everybody?
Dog.
How did you know?
A dog
is covered in fur, makes that noise.
Here, a polar bear.
All right, here's an animal.
Polar bears
go.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm getting close to one. They might if it's a hot day. Here's an animal. It's covered in hard pieces that keep it strong. Sometimes it crawls in the sand.
Turtle.
Sometimes it's in the hot sun. Covered in. It's got a long tail, claws, a tongue.
I think it's a crocodile.
It could be something covered in scales, right? So that could be a
crocodile,
lizard, maybe even a turtle. What?
Crabs.
Crabs. I don't know if crabs are covered in scales. They're covered in hard shells, though. So we talked about things covered in fur, covered in skin, and covered in scales. The last thing,
Dolphin.
And this thing has flies, and it covers. It's covered in what?
Feathers.
This week we're going to talk about how animals are alike and different. Can you read this together with me?
Yeah. How are animals alike and different?
How are animals alike and different? And so you see here. Five different animals, and we're going to make we have on the board there, we have a chart. So let's look at all, first of all, let's see what animals they are. What is this animal?
Snake.
Snake, and it's actually called a garter snake.
Garter.
Garter, everybody say garter snake.
Garter.
Get back in your pockets there. What is this animal? That's actually a green leopard frog.
What? Green leopard frog.
And here is a...
Fish.
And that is actually a fish called a wrasse or a sea bass.
A wrasse.
And what is this?
Giraffe.
A giraffe.
And a bird.
And this is a...
Bird.
And it's a red bird.
A zebra.
Let's take... I don't see a zebra.
A cardinal.
A cardinal. Very good.
I thought that was a robin.
I know it could be a robin, but this is our state bird, Indiana. Let's take a closer look at these. Okay, so we got our chart ready. Let's first look at the garter snake. How is the garter snake like all of these animals? I love how you raise your hand. You're my favorite student for raising your hand. How is the garter snake like all of these animals? It has what? It has eyes. Look, does the frog have eyes?
Yeah.
Fish?
No.
Giraffe?
No.
They have eyes?
Yeah, they have eyes.
And what about the bird?
No.
Yes. So that's very good. All of these have eyes. Look how she wrote eyes up there. Very good. Let's look next at the giraffe. How is the giraffe like all of these animals? That's a hard one. You probably haven't seen a giraffe unless you've been to the zoo. I got to see giraffes in Africa when I went on a safari. And when they run, they look so beautiful. Their neck kind of goes, dum, dum. How is a giraffe like all these animals? What? They all go to the bathroom. Very good. They have to get rid of their wastes.
In the house?
No. They do do out in the wild. So they get rid of their waste. They eliminate waste. What else? How is the giraffe like all these animals? They're all animals, which means they can all move. The giraffe can move. Can the bird move?
No.
Yes.
Think before you shout.
Yes.
Can a fish move?
Yes.
Can a frog move?
Yes.
Can a snake move?
Yes.
So,
every animal can move.
If it's an animal, it has the ability to move. Thank you for sharing that with me. What about the red bird? How is the red bird like all of these animals here? Think. Yes, sir. They all have feet. Are you sure? He said all these animals have feet.
No.
I'm thinking there's two animals that don't have feet here. What two animals don't have feet?
Snake and fish.
Yeah, snake and fish. Sorry. Nice try. Come on. What does the bird have that nobody, that everybody has? I'm thinking. What do you think? A mouth. Is that true? Can you? What'd you say? They do have a mouth, right? Look, does the snake have a mouth?
Yes.
Does the frog have a mouth?
Yes.
Fish?
Yes.
Giraffe?
Yes.
What are you looking? Take a look at that giraffe. He's got his mouth open and a big long tongue. And what about the bird? Now the bird has a mouth that's covered in a beak. All right. What about the fish? How is the fish? Always the same smart kids raising their hand. What about you guys over here? How is a fish like all of these animals? Think.
No idea.
Check your brain again. There's an idea in there.
Keep thinking in there.
Yes.
I'm going to lighten you again.
Okay, but not all of them. Ah, she says some of them have scales. Which two have scales? As long as we're talking about that. A fish and a snake. A fish and a snake. Excellent. They have scales, but here we have skin, fur, feathers. Sorry. How are they all like? Yes. How? Oh, I love that. Hear what she said? The fish is alive. These are all alive. Beautiful observation. What else?
They both have bodies.
They all have bodies. They all have bodies. Yes. They are all types of skin. What about the last one, which is the frog? How is the frog like all of these guys? What do you think? Yes? The frog, yes? It'll come back to you. I'll come back to you. How is the frog? Oh, you have an idea in that head? They all drink water. That's so good. The snake needs water, the frog needs water, the fish needs water. That's a pretty good job on how they are alike. I want you to think and look at these animals carefully. How is each one different? Because this lesson is how our animals are alike and different. Let's start with the garter snake. What is different about the snake than all of these animals? Yes, sir.
It slithers.
It slithers. It has no feet or hands. Very good. Do you hear what he said? It slithers. Can anybody think of another thing about the snake? Dry scales? That's what he was trying to say, isn't it? It has scales, but then you saw the fish, and you know the fish has scales, but it has dry scales. Very good. Let's take a look at the frog. How is the frog different than everything? Yes, sir. The frog, how is it different? It jumps. Let's see. Does a snake jump?
No.
A bird doesn't really jump.
No.
It flies. The giraffe really doesn't jump. It's too tall already. So, okay, a frog will jump. That's pretty good. It hop jumps. Anything else about the frog? Yes.
The frog is a different type of color.
He's a different color. His skin is kind of green, right?
Yeah.
This guy's a little green, too. Let's think about, yes, you have something about the frog? What? Oh, it has webbed feet. That's a good one. This one has no feet. A hoof, claws, no feet. Let's go to the next one, which is the giraffe. How is the giraffe different from anything? Yes?
He got a big, long neck.
Look at that long neck he has. Isn't that something? Long neck. What else about the giraffe? He's the tallest animal of all these. That's excellent. And what else about the giraffe?
It has a long tail.
It does have a long tail for swishing. And now let's move to this red bird right here. How is this bird different than all these animals? This one may be pretty interesting. Yes, sir. Did you hear that? He said that the red bird can
fly.
What else about the bird? It's the only one with the claws. Look here, yeah, that's a great observation. Hoofs, no feet, web feet, claws. One more about the bird? Yes, my dear.
It has feathers.
It has feathers. That's good. That ties in what we learned last week. So we've done the snake, the frog, the giraffe, the bird. That leaves this fish, my favorite. I love fish. How is the fish different? Yes, sir.
It swims.
But you know what? It swims, but a snake can swim on top of the water. A frog can swim. Where does a fish swim?
Underwater.
It lives underwater.
In a fish bowl.
Well, it could live in a fish bowl, but even in a fish bowl, is it going to be on top of the water or
underwater?
So this guy might visit the water. He might visit the water, but this one swims under the water. Anything else about the fish? Yes. Yeah, it's got stripes, but you know what? The snake has stripes too. Colors can be different. One more comment. Yes.
It has wet scales.
It has scales? Yes, wet scales. Very good. You remember from the snake that had dry scales. All right, we're going to do one more thing. We talked about how animals are alike or different. We need to talk about their size. Are all animals the same size?
No!
No. In fact, I'm going to show you two animals. One that's going to be very, very
big.
And one that's going to be very, very,
yeah.
Let's see, maybe, like a what?
Like a mouse and a hippopotamus.
How did you know it was going to be a mouse and a hippopotamus? So which one would you say is the larger? Is that a hippopotamus?
Yeah.
You call it a, what do you call it?
Hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. Say, everybody say that.
Hippopotamus.
And so what is this then?
Mouse.
Mouse. So we can tell that, read this with me.
How big are some animals?
How big are some animals? So here's, I'm gonna ask you three hard questions. Who can tell me an animal that's smaller than a hippopotamus and smaller than a mouse? An ant, very good. Would you guys agree? You're gonna say ant? Raise your hand if you're gonna say ant. That's a popular choice. Can anybody think of another animal smaller than an ant? Another animal smaller than an ant. Would you pick on something, Ms. Woolery?
Sure. Eli just told me really good.
Eli what?
Ladybug.
A ladybug. All right, here's a, this one may be hard too. Ms. Woolery, pick a student. What animal is larger than a hippopotamus? Larger than a hippopotamus. What do you think?
Let's see. Donovan, what do you think?
What did he say? An elephant. An elephant's bigger than a hippopotamus. Very good. I'm thinking of something that lives in the water under the ocean that's really big. I'm trying to. Bigger than a hippopotamus. I like how you raise your hand. What? A whale shark. Excellent. All right, here's the hard question, Ms. Lori. Can you pick a student that can tell me an animal that's bigger than a mouse but smaller than a hippopotamus? That's a tricky one.
No, it's not.
It is.
I am.
Like what type of medium-sized fish you talking about?
Like the one on the front page.
Oh, like a big sea bass? A sea bass is bigger than a mouse, but smaller than a hippopotamus. Very good. What else?
Let's see. Sage, what do you think?
What do you think? Bigger than a mouse. What? A sheep. Perfect. A sheep is about that big. Hippopotamus is about that big. And a mouse is about that big. One more.
One more. Okay. Jennifer.
A whale. Do you think? What do you think? Have you seen a whale maybe? They're pretty big. I got one. Would you stand up right here? What about this guy? Is he big? Turn around and face. Is he bigger than a mouse?
No.
Yes.
About this big. Are you bigger than a mouse?
Yes.
Are you bigger than a hippopotamus?
No.
He's
smaller than a hippopotamus.
You're smaller than a hippopotamus, but bigger than a mouse. All right. Grow some more. We'll see you later. All right. Let's take a closer look at some animals that are alive.
All right, so Mr. Crosslin has brought some friends to visit with us today. But before we can meet those friends and pass them around, there are some rules that we must follow, okay? All right, so rule number one, show me your number one. Rule number one, stay seated and use your eyes and your ears to observe. Got it? Rule number two. Show me your twos. All right. Rule number two. Do not touch any animal without permission. That means a grown-up must tell you when you can touch an animal. Got that? Okay. Thumbs up if you got it. Rule number three. Show me your threes. Good. Wash your hands before and after
you touch your animal.
Touching any animal. Thumbs up if you got that. All right. Rule number four. Show me your fours. All of those animals over there, they could bite. That is why they have a mouth and teeth. So I think you should probably keep your hands away from the mouth. Thumbs up if you understand that. All right. And then last one, Aiden. Rule number five. Show me your five. Never, ever, 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 ever scare anyone with an animal.
What?
That's just mean, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thumbs up if you understand that.
Hey, that was a great list of rules for animals. And those animal rules keep the animals safe. And it keeps us safe. So the first thing I'm going to do is, since we're going to hold some animals, I'm going to make sure my hands are clean because I don't want to get the animal sick with something that might be on my hands. Let's take a look at the first animal. We're going to see how these animals are alike and different. And here's our first animal. You notice I got him in a nice cage. And it is a milk snake. Here we go. He's fast. Now, I notice some of you seem a little worried. Don't worry.
I'm not touching.
Do we have any? You're not following the rules. Remember, the rules say that you can't touch it unless you have permission. Now, unless one of you guys smell like a mouse, everything's going to be okay because he will eat a mouse. But first of all, let's see how he is like all animals. Does he have feet?
No.
Does he have legs?
No.
Does he have feathers?
No.
So who can tell me what is he covered in? Yes. I want you to take a look at the scales on top. The scales on top of him are like triangular shape, but the scales on the bottom, if you look on the bottom here, these scales are big and flat. Can you see that?
Yes.
Okay, you notice what he's done. He has crawled around my wrist.
Can I move in the back?
And when I do that, he likes to be comfortable around my wrist. And you notice what is he flicking out all the time?
His tongue.
His tongue. Watch, here it goes. When he does it, you do it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there goes.
When he does it, you do it. Ready? When he does it, oh. Now, if you look carefully at his tongue, it's actually split, so it's not straight, it's like that. And that means he can taste more things in the air. Now, let me tell you where his tail, you might just find this interesting. Let me show you where his tail starts. There's his head, here's his body, here's his body, here's his body. Here's his body, here's his body, here's his body, here's his body. Here's where he goes to the bathroom, right there. And only that part is his tail. Only that part's his tail. So his tail's not that long. Now this is covered in scales. And how does it move? Show me with your hand how it moves. Let me hear the word how it moves.
Slither.
Okay. What does he have to do first?
What does he have to do first, friend?
Wash his hands.
A little bit of squirt, rub it in there.
Squirt, rub it in really
While
good.
We're doing that, this is called a milk snake. It does not drink milk, but it was often found around places where there might be cows because it eats. It doesn't eat cows. It eats mice that you might find in a barn. Come over here, young man. Let's have a sit down right there on your knees. Okay. Squat down on your knees.
There you go.
What's your name?
Brian.
Brian. Whenever you look at an animal, the first thing you do is I let you start with the tail, because the tail doesn't hurt you. How does he feel?
Warm.
Warm. How else does he feel? Does he feel wet and slimy?
Yeah.
He does?
Yeah.
He's wet? Rub your hand like that and look at your hand. Is there any wet there?
See any water?
So he's actually dry, isn't he?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, you feel comfortable with this holding it like that?
Yeah.
Okay. Hold him up like that. Let him crawl through your fingers. In fact, let's try him right like this. How's that?
It's okay.
It's okay? You're still okay?
It's slithering.
It is slithering. I'll put him right here and see what he does.
I got him.
You got him? Okay. Good man. Just keep him away from your nose.
Wow, Brian. Look at you.
I didn't hold a snake before.
You haven't held a snake before? Very good.
Okay.
All right, I'll hold him. Let's give him a round of applause. Nice, nice job. Brian, slither on back to your seat, okay? Okay, check this out. A lot of people don't know this, but snakes are very good at
climbing.
Whoa.
Let it
jump. Let's
go
take us.
Whoa.
And they are good climbers.
Whoa.
What could a snake find up in a tree that he might want to eat?
Mice
don't usually go up in trees. What goes up in trees?
Bird.
A bird. And so he likes to climb and see. Come back this way, Mr. Snake, would you please? So you see he's way up there. Can you guys see him? Because I can see you. There he is. Come on, Snakey Snake, time to get down. He doesn't want to get down, does he? Well, so what have you learned about snakes so far? What have you learned about snakes? Yes. A snake can do what?
Slither.
A snake can slither. What else? And climb. What is a snake covered in? I better get him, huh? Do you think I better get him?
No!
Okay. Okay, there's one more thing before I put him away. I don't know if you noticed, but the skin underneath his head is starting to come off because a snake sheds its skin. In the next couple days, he's going to peel all that skin off and it'll be even more beautiful than he is now. Let's put him away and take a look at the next animal. And see how it's alive. The next animal that I want to share with you. And I like you said, does it bite? Everything that has a mouth can bite. That's why it's got a mouth. And so this one is not covered in fur. It's not covered in skin. It's not covered in feathers. It's not covered in scales. This animal is covered in a hard shell. In fact, it's not a turtle, but it's a type of an insect. And it's called a hissing cockroach. And I have several of them. They eat plant material. And they're very beautiful. Let's see, if it's an animal, it can what?
Bite.
No, it can move. But here's what makes this a hissy cockroach. Listen, listen. Did you hear it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't hear it. You have to listen. I'll see if this guy, he doesn't want to hiss too much today. Listen to this guy. Now he makes sounds by air coming out of the side of him. Now he's got three body parts. He's got a head. The head is underneath. The head is really kind of small. And that's the thorax. And this is the abdomen. Can you count how many legs he has?
Six.
And he's got an antenna. And he... You're excited about this one, huh? And let's see here. There's one. I had like six. There's only four in here. I don't...
Angie took two home.
No, there's four in here.
Sorry.
And... They like to move around a lot.
I want to touch it.
In fact, let's see. Here's another one. How are these alike? I really like how you're sitting and observing.
Very nice.
Yeah. How are they alike?
Listen.
The snake we just saw. The snake and the cockroaches can both... Move.
Move. Mm-hmm. Bite.
They can both bite. Yeah.
They can both
okay.
Climb.
Let's have a volunteer. Right. Your friend. Now here's what we're gonna do. Just so you don't get too frightened, put your hand out and let it touch you. It's gonna be ticklish.
Ew.
What do you think about that?
It tickles.
It does tickle. Let me know. Now, if you pull your hand back, you may go flying across the room and land on your teacher. So try
don't
not to
do
pull.
That.
How does he feel?
Making it.
Tickles. Do you want him to crawl up your hand or no?
No.
All right, here's what you do. Put your other hand like that on top. He'll crawl on that hand. Closer to him. Very good. Here he comes. Ding, 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 ding. And he gets on that hand. Move it way out here now. And now you can switch hands like that. Have him crawl up on that hand. See how you're doing the old cockroach shuffle? Now what are you going to do? Move that hand and put this hand up on top. There you go. Good job. Now, let's try something else. You ready? Listen, ready? Here you go. Listen, listen, listen.
He's hissing at you, Amalia.
He likes you.
I'm going to try one.
All right, Anaya, can we put him on your shirt?
No.
Well, thanks for telling me no. You know, Sage, they have really good claws for climbing. So all the more than be still. Go back to your friends and say
that.
Let me know. I'll get them off when you don't like them. Nice job, Sage. Really good. Did you get that one?
Yeah.
Right now? Okay. I'm moving down.
I want
Sage, quiet, please. Oh, you want them off? Sage, you're really bugging me, man. You want him off? You want to take him off? Or you want me to take him off?
You.
All right.
I won't touch him.
All right. That's all right. Here's one. Which one next?
That one.
That one. Okay. Which one next?
That one.
All right, that one next. So hopefully you guys, I want you to fill out that chart. Let's give a round of applause. Good job. This next one, I have a hard time finding this guy. So I'm looking, and I don't even see him. I don't even know where he's at.
He's right there.
I don't see him. I just see
he's
this bark. He's where is he?
He's right there.
I don't see him.
He's right there.
You mean on this bark? This tree?
No, yeah.
I just see a tree. Why don't I see him?
Because he's camouflaged like a tree.
Oh, what is the word, is he?
Camouflaged.
You think he's camouflaged? Does he look like that tree?
Yeah.
Well, this... Oh, wait a minute. I see him. If he moves, maybe I can see him.
You look creepy.
I look creepy? That's not very nice.
Do I look creepy?
I love him. I love him.
You look creepy.
Thanks a lot.
I love that.
Oh, there he is. I see his head poking up. This guy is a...
A lizard.
A bearded dragon lizard. Now, he's not covered in fur.
He's covered in scales.
And if I go like this, watch. He's very bumpy, but if I go like this, ow, oh, he's very spiky. So the scales all point back. He also has a tail, four legs, and watch. He's so good with his claws. Watch what I'm gonna do. Ready? What is he doing now? And he's hanging upside down. Let me see if I can get him on my hand here. Ready? He has very sharp claws.
Are we gonna be able to hold that one?
And he likes to climb. He has eyes, ears, and a mouth. And let's look at his belly. Check out his belly. His belly looks different. Look at it.
It looks wet.
He's not wet. But Daniel, I'm going to ask you a question. What does it look like it's covered in?
Lion.
Scales. Take your finger, start at the head, and rub back to his tail. Start here and go like that. Tell me what it feels like. How's it feel?
Bumpy.
Now make your finger go the other way. How's that feel?
Spiky.
See, the scales go in one direction. Put your hand out, let him touch your claw, or your claws. Feel the claws. Here, put your hand out and let him grab them. What do you think? How does that feel? Tickles. Put your hood up. Let's try something. Put your hood up. You have a hood?
Uh-oh.
He likes to climb. Are you ready for this?
He's going to put the hood on your head.
You want him to climb up your arm onto your head?
Yeah.
No. All right. Well, you want to touch him or hold him before we go? All right. Go ahead. Touch him. And look how Nathaniel's not touching by the head. You want to touch him on his head? Or no? No. Okay, that's a safe bet. All right. Have a seat. Maybe we can have someone with a hood. We'll try some. Who's got a hood on? Who wants to try? Are you okay? All right. Let's see. This guy likes to climb. So, Donovan, our deal is going to put him on your arm. Let's see if he'll climb on up. Let's see if he'll keep climbing. Let's see if we'll put him up here and see where he goes. Where do you think he's going to go?
Go!
Let's see if he'll go on up there a little bit further.
Donovan.
Is it Donovan?
Donovan.
Donovan, look your head up. Donovan, that's a strange hat you have on. You want to turn around slowly so everybody can see? Turn around slowly. Keep turning, keep turning. Keep going. Donovan, Donovan, you know you have a lizard on your head?
Hey, look over here and say she's talking to the pictures of your mommy.
Can you make your head go like a lizard?
And
see your claws? And you can see your claws? Put your claws out. No claws? All right, let's try it. Thank you, Donovan. Would you take your hood off and stand right there? Get on your knees for a second. Get on your knees. Now here's something we're going to try. Donovan, you hold this. And I know that bearded dragons like to eat things that are yellow. Let's see. Watch him. Watch. Let's see if he goes for it. Watch what he does. Let's see.
He's hungry.
Hold it tight. Hold it tight. He's going to pull it off. You got it? Tight. Hold it. He's going for it.
Whatever it is.
You see his pink tongue?
Yeah.
And he's got sharp teeth for cutting vessels. I dropped a few leaves. Here we go. Hold on the stem, dude.
Hold on tight, Donovan.
Hold tight. Don't let him eat the stem. Donovan, what happened to the flower?
Did you eat it?
How was that?
He ate the whole thing.
Donovan, we have one left over. Do you want to eat it?
He
may not eat the next one. We'll find out. Let's see. Let's see if he's hungry enough to eat this one right here. Got it? Let's see. Yeah, let's see if he'll eat this. He may not eat it because, wait, there he goes. Donovan, you're very brave, and you fed the bearded dragon dandelion flowers, and he thanks you for
it. He's really hungry.
Three animals, a snake.
Can we touch him?
I think he's hungry.
He might be. A hissing cockroaches and a bearded dragon. And you guys did a really good job with this. Okay, so we had a lot of fun today learning about how animals are alike and different, and Mrs. Woolery has got a lot of courage. And go ahead, you've ever held something with scales before?
No, I have not.
Okay, and he feels kind of, you're doing a very good job on that. Breathe. Say something. And tell your class something about this animal.
He has scales. He can move. And he has sharp teeth or claws. He has sharp claws.
Okay, I'll let you go ahead and feed this to him. And we'll see if he'll eat. Here we go. He might. He might be full.
He might be full.
Well, hey guys, thanks for letting me come in and work with the kindergartners here at Chapelwood to learn about how animals are alike and different. You're doing a good job.
Thank you.